Rishi. Old man Karaba says, oh, you are here? Avon says, Grandpa Karaba, long time no see. Mr. Avon, you came back from the Holy Capital? Glad to see you again. Please come in. Thanks, Grandpa. Where is Archem? Archem says, Grandpa, who's here? Avon? Hi, Archem. Looks like you are doing good. It's been a while, Avon. Coming to see us means you could fulfill the mission of your journey? So that's Imel, I suppose? How do you do? Says Rutis. I'm Rutis. I'm supporting him on his journey. Ms. Rutis? Says Archem. I'm Lucius. I'm their escort. Nice meeting you. Hi! Nice meeting you too. Avon, you haven't found your sister yet? And Miles not with you? Avon says, I don't have much time, so I'll explain it to you briefly. I need to lend a power of Meefas and you, Archem. Avon explained to Old Man Karaba and Archem what had happened during his journey. He also told them that the Garden Hill is covered with poisonous minute scales. So that's what happened to Mr. Mile. Okay, he told them that too. That's bad news. Where is Bardas when we need him? Archem says, Avon, I don't know what to say. She starts crying. Haha, you don't have to cry, Archem. Well, that's a weird thing to say. For now, we have a mission to collect the sacred treasures to rescue Imel. I don't have time to feel down much.
The sacred treasures? So you collect shattered souls of God and temper thoroughly a sword in which the power of Bardas dwells. That's a hard mission to accomplish.
Avon, says Archem, please let me help you. I can use white spells even though I may not look like it. I know I can be of great help. Yeah, she was on our party before, right? She's got some good healing spells. Thank you for your offer, but this is a real fight with the Apostles of Darkness. I can't let you get involved in it. But, listen, Archem. It may sound cruel, but are you able to hurt others, Archem? Depending on the circumstances, you might hurt and rob someone of their lives. Do you think you can bear that, Archem? If you can't do it, you'll be a drag on us.
Avon, says Rutis.
There are things you can say and can't say. Archem says, no, it's all right. I know I'm chicken and I'm not suited for fighting. I may be your burden if I go with you. But at least let me go with you to the Garden Hill. You'll need someone who can understand Meefa's language, too.
But,
says Avon.
Lucia says, hey, Avon, stop being so stubborn. You are worried about her and treat her in a cold way on purpose, but you are the one who said we haven't got much time.
I didn't treat her coldly on purpose.
I see, says Rutis.
I'm for it, Archem. The Garden Hill is covered with poisonous minute scales. You'll be a great help since you know white spells.
Rutis, thank you.
What's going on, says Avon. So, am I the only bad guy here?
Gaff.
Who's Gaff?
It's hard to be a man sometimes. Don't worry about Archem. She can even walk freely in the woods with monsters wandering around. Please take her with you.
Okay. But only to the Garden Hill, all right?
Sure, says Archem.
Then let's call them. Archem inhaled deeply. She yells Meefas. Oh, she's singing? That's like not human. I have a favor to ask you, says Archem.
A kind spirit of a wind which delivers life to the woods is in trouble. We need your help.
Mimu. Mun.
Thanks, everyone. Go to the village called the Garden Hill on the top of the mountain.
Mun Mun.
They are gone, says Retis. Where did Meefas go? Where did the Meefas go? Archem says, they can take an animal trail so they can get to the Garden Hill much quicker than us. They said they will go ahead and go to purify the air. What an amazing animal, says Lucius.
Looks like you were able to gain cooperation from the Meefas. Archem, don't get in Mr. Avon's way, okay?
Stop it, Grandpa. I gotta get going to Garden Hill.
Be careful.
Archem joined the party. Alright. So, now we gotta run all the way back there. A light flail. Battle beak is much better, so boop. Tonky shield. How about night shield? Boop. Ring mail. I don't have an extra set of plate mail or anything else, actually. Speed helps a little bit here. Magic attack and defense a little bit. Avoidance way up with the forest cape. I do like the forest cape. Attack up 18. Defense and magic attack. This helps a lot of things. How about the bond earrings? That's good too. Circle it. It's up to the circlet or the power vest. That's like 18 more attack. Defense. And we get the circlet. Oh. Else from him.
Spirit Idun delivers life to the woods. Moreover, the source of water for the whole region is a spring that flows out of the Garden Hill. If we leave this alone, this woods will suffer greatly too. By the way, you look a little tired. I know you're in a great hurry, but if you collapse now, you'll have to be back at where you started. Why don't you take a rest?
Sure.
I'm sleeping a lot. Come back anytime when you get tired.
Full of those again. Oh, wait. No.
Do not want.
Yeah. Deadly. No one's gonna be leveling up for a while.
Oops. Oh. Rarer. Needs healing. I mean, it really barely makes a difference, but... Oops. All right. I know this isn't the way. Just want to look around a little bit. But there's not much to see, so let's get out of here. I throw the stimulant at the wandering monster. Oh wow. Kill both of them. Nice. Oh, Archem's at level 25, so she's really the only one getting experience at this point. And she's not gonna be with us for long, unfortunately. No, thank you. Oh. Wind lullaby. Music of forest give calmness. Oh, they have little sheep in them. Did I ever see that? That's pretty cool. Figured she just put them to sleep and not hurt them. Now they put her to sleep. Oh. We don't even want to be going here, right? We gotta go to... We have to go out... Do you have to go out the other way? Hold on a second. We have to go out the west way. No, maybe not. The east way? Doesn't seem like. Let's hurry to Garden Hill. The Meefas are waiting for us, she says. Alright. So it's not that way. None of the signs say Garden Hill.
Let's check to make sure that this might be the way. They'll stop me if it isn't.
We should hurry our way to Garden Hill. I'm sure the Meefas are holding out for us.
Holding out for us? Is there a south way out? No, I don't think so. Alright, we've... I don't think we're supposed to come in here at all. I don't think anyone's gonna say anything new. Doubt it. So it's gotta be this way. Somewhere. I'm sure it'll come to me. You're here. It would just bring us there. Let's just let the screen fade out, fade back in, and we'll be there. West Garden Hill. Get back to the Grand Canyon. Alright. At least we can take the express elevator. Maybe they put some, like, guardrail or ropes around or something so we can hold on to. God forbid anyone stumble and fall off. Avon says, the air is clean now. Lucia says, is it because the power of those little ones? I can't believe it, says Retis. Mune, mune, mune. Oh, everyone, says Archem. Thank you so much, all of you. Mune, mune. We appreciate what you've done for us, says Avon. You did well, little ones, Lucia says. Lucia's smiling, look at that. Witty says, thank you, you helped us. Mew mew. Hey, says Witty. Wow, says Lucia. Archem chuckles. Witty, Lucia, I think they like you. It's an honor, really, says Lucia. Witty says, chuckles, and says, good kids. Avon says, thanks to the Meefas, the air in Garden Hill has been cleaned. We should head for the Idun Shrine before something else happens. Ruti says, let's ask Rethal to open the door. I hope his power has returned. Lucia says, anyway, let's go to the Elder's house first. Archem says, wait for us here, alright? I thought she was going to leave the party. Yum yum. One of them's gonna say something like, do you have any Grey Poupon? Finally, I stopped seeing these flickers in my eyes. The Meefa must be an animal of incredible power. Oh crap. I don't want to go in there. Ugh. I want to get around. You just knock down some of these walls, make it easier for someone to get to you. I'm already half knocked down anyway. The Meefas came to help us this time, but you may not be able to get help all the time. I'll purchase items that can shield scales effectively.
Okay. What would that be?
They are the Meefas who help newborn, right? I've heard about them, but they are very cute indeed.
Who's that boy?
Hi.
Mew?
Oh, says Archem. Avon says, this one is holding something in the mouth. It's a book, says Archem. I wonder where they found it.
Ooh. Maybe the next Swordmaster book? Because we get all the Quick Raven books from, what's his name? That agent guy.
Mew. What? Are you giving it to me, says Archem?
Mew.
Take that as a yes, thank you.
Cool, we got Swordmaster 10.
Mew?
Wow, that's random. That's why you go around and talk to everybody. That's the latest one. Come up here.
I don't need that.
Alright, talk to you. I'm looking for that boy.
Oh, here he is.
My mind became clear after smelling this guy. You have a great power, don't you, little one?
Oh, that's those two.
I'll visit them after I find the guy who fixes the elevators.
Oh, and her.
Those animals must be Eden's messenger. We must receive the guest hospitably.
Hospitably.
I don't know if that's spelled right. And treat them well.
Well, they might be a messenger. They could just be animals.
Oh, there's one over here.
Himyun.
Look, these two sisters.
Oh, there's more of them.
My sister says she wants to make lunch for the Meefas. She doesn't even know what they eat. Archem says their favorite foods are fruit and bread, but they eat anything humans eat. They don't like spicy food, so be careful of what spices you use when seasoning. Seasoning is a major problem, says Malin. I must watch my sister closely so that she won't cook horribly.
Just let you talk crap about her like that.
Okay.
After the Meefas ran around the house, the twinkling phosphorus powder was gone.
Twinkling phosphorus powder. I thought it was minute scales.
So was the dizziness my sister and I had.
We're going to fix lunch for the Meefas to thank them for saving us. This will be a major cooking exercise we haven't done in a while.
I mean, you haven't done for a while.
She's just gonna watch you.
Alright, where's this guy?
We want to talk to them, but...
guy's over here somewhere.
Oh, here he is.
Meefas live in forests, don't they? I appreciate their coming to our place of such a high altitude. We're truly grateful.
You know, her cooking might be horrible because she hasn't learned to cook right for the altitude.
You know, like bread won't rise and stuff like that, or yeast won't rise.
Yeah, Mew. Okay, let's go talk to them.
They're... where are they again? They're this way, somewhere.
I might miss this item. Wait.
I Is this these two? They're right over here somewhere. Yunmin. No, it can't be this far east. Just making sure that no one's got another book. That's really hard to find. I mean, who would go around talking to all these Meefas? Expecting one of them to have a book. So there's 12 Swordmaster books. Two more to go. I think they're more north-ish. Sorry guys, I just saw them. Wasn't this where they were? They moved. Because I remember the stairs were right here. But I know I did just see them. It's just they're in a separate area though where they were before. Ah, here they are. Wraithwall says, "Oh, you are back. As you can see, the air in Garden Hill has completely returned to normal. I don't know how to thank you." "We didn't do anything," says Avon. "You should thank the Meefa instead." I guess he means plural. If the plural of Meefa is Meefas. I give up on this. And also Archem right here. "Oh, so you are the one who called the Meefas." Wraithwall says, "You can talk with the sacred animal. You have such a wonderful gift." "Well, thank you," says Archem. Archem blushed as if she was embarrassed. She is embarrassed. "Well, I hear that the wind spirit was cast a spell and is in a state of agony. We must help the spirit at once." Avon says, "Wraithwall, could you open the entrance?" "Okay, let's go to the Idun Shrine then." See, now we just get teleported there. I could have walked here, this is close. "I'll open the entrance to the shrine now." It's all sparkly and stuff. Very sparkly, very twinkly. Very rumbly. Okay. We'll be going inside now. "We'll go and see Idun. You wait here, Wraithwall," says Avon. Bossy. "Okay. Idun is controlled by an evil spirit. Please release him from pain." Idun is controlled by an evil spirit and release him. Okay. Okay. So we will try to release him from pain, but that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.